Aaron Tebbigs here in the IPL. Today, we have a week two team prep for Alpha and the San Diego Wim Padres. So, I'm surprised I've been doing really well about getting the teams up. I just forgot to do that. You'll have already seen the team above my head, but I can't remember it off the top of my head. So anyways, we have Latias, Excadrill, Scolipede, Vaporeon, Darmanitan, Tyranitar, Miltank, Gorgeist, Primarina, Nidoqueen, and Miss Major. So he's got a pretty intimidating team. Definitely what scares me on the team is the Darmanitan, because the Darmanitan could kind of run through my team. I do have a couple Pokemon that are able to resist its hits and whatnot, but it's kind of a scary Pokemon in general. Stop trying to trade me, people. Gee whiz. Anyways, the T-Tar could be interesting. He's got the T-Tar Excadrill, so we could be doing Sand Rush. I was debating on bringing Sand Veil Gliscor, so he's got some pretty interesting Pokemon, and hopefully I built a good enough team to get past him. But I did have some help from other people, of course, as per usual. So anyways, here is the first Pokemon we're bringing today is Escalators and Sylvested Electros with Drain Punch, Thunderbolt, U-Turn, and Knock Off. Drain Punch is pretty decent. He's got that bulky Miltank, he's got the Tyranitar, so it hits those things super hard. It also hits Excadrill extremely hard, which is really nice. Obviously, he does have the two ghost types that are immune to it, and he does have a psychic and like two other poison types. So overall, fighting is not great against his team, but it can be very helpful against that Miltank, otherwise, or even the T-Tar, because both of them can kind of sit in here on Electros and be decent enough when it comes to that. It's pretty cool stuff. Thunderbolt is just to hit super hard. He's got that Vaporeon and the Primarina, both of which are very, very irritating Pokemon. Primarina is a great offensive Pokemon. Vaporeon is a great defensive Pokemon, so having that electric to hit them and do a lot of damage would be really nice, because I don't know if this guy gets like Energy Ball or something like that. I would assume this thing's got an incredible move pool. It does not get Energy Ball. It gets Giga Drain, though. Giga Drain's pretty good. But I decided to do a U-Turn because he has a ground, he is the ground type in the Nidoqueen and the Excadrill, so Volt Switch would be able to be easily absorbed by that, and U-Turn hits everything. Obviously, hits everything. He's only got a couple resistances, though, which is actually really nice, so pretty cool stuff. And then Knock Off is really good for getting rid of items on his entire team, because it'll do a lot of damage to Gorgeist and Miss Mages and Latias, and Latias could be very, very intimidating with its very good speed. Getting that thing with a Knock Off could be very, very good for me in the long run. Get rid of like a life orb, or if decides to scarf it, which I almost kind of doubt, but you know, anyway, so pretty cool stuff. Miss Magus could also be a very big issue for my team, but Assault Vest should help me against those three Pokemon that I was talking about. Gorgeist is more physical, but it's not as much of an offensive threat as the other two, so pretty cool stuff. We're rocking Max Attack with 12 and Special Attack with a Quiet Nature, so I can hit a little I can do some decent damage when it comes to special attacking, and I was able to put more in attack when it comes to that. That's why I decided to run it like this. I was thinking about adding more to special attack, but I felt this was the best idea, because the only special move I'm running is Thunderbolt, and it's only for two specific Pokemon. So, pretty cool stuff. Yeah, there's Escalators. Next up, we have Atlas, the Terrakion with the Rocky MZ, Stone Edge, Earthquake, Close Combat, Stealth Rock's a very similar set. I didn't get to use him to his full potential last week, or use him at all. Really, I didn't really get the opportunity to use anybody last week. Last week was just a shit show for me. Overall, with his team, Rock does so well against it. Now, the only resistances he has to Rock being Excadrill and Nidoqueen. Ground resist Rock. So, those are the only things that actually resist Rock on his team, and Rocky MZ will still do a hell of a lot to the Excadrill, not as much to the Nidoqueen, but Earthquake handles both of those. This thing outspeeds both, provided they are not scarfed, and yeah, Close Combat's very nice for the T-Tar Miltank. As I mentioned already, he's got the Pokemon that are immune to it and whatnot. He's got the couple ghost types and the Latias, which is very, very good against it, but overall, this should work out when it comes to things, so pretty cool stuff. I don't even know what I'm talking about. And yeah, I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory. Overall, Atlas is really good. Stealth Rocks can be very nice to get some chip damage on Scolipede and Darmanitan. That's mainly the reason I'm bringing it. They're not key to the match, but they'd be very, very, very helpful. So yeah, as you see, we're running enough speed, down speed, max speed, miss. Magus being base 105. Put the rest in special defense and max attack with the Jolly Natures. This thing can be speedy. So pretty cool stuff. Next up, we have Tobin the Gliscor. Once again, I didn't get to use him last week. Toxic Orb, Poison Heal, Knockoff, Earthquake, Stone Edge, and Swords Dance. So this thing is meant to be an offensive hazard. This thing is just meant to hit super hard, and that's the way we're running it this week. I was debating on doing the Sand Veil. The people that had helped me build and whatnot didn't really go with that as much as I did. I felt like it was a good idea taking advantage of the sand, and then I could run. Earthquake would hit both the two Pokemon that benefit really from the sand. So, I mean, the three, considering Nidoqueen as well. Pretty much that's about it. Knockoff, as I mentioned, is good for the two ghost types and the Latias. It can be very nice. Earthquake hits everything but the Latias and the, let's see, what else? The Miss Magus, who has Levitate. So overall, it does pretty decently against the rest of his team. Stone Edge does well against those Pokemon that are levitating. The Miss Mage, actually, Knockoff does better against the Levitators. So that's really, really nice. Swords Dance is just, if I get the opportunity to set up, this thing could be a hazard because he doesn't have much that's really good for this Pokemon. Primarina is about his best counter. I mean, Nidoqueen can hit hard with the Ice Beam, but I don't believe it can one-shot me. So, you know, it's going to be very, very interesting. And yeah, so we're running a lot of attack investment, a good amount of special defense and HP so I can live a hit. I was also debating on bringing Sand Veil Yachi Berry. We ended up just going Toxic Poison Heal. So, pretty cool stuff. And yeah, so next up we have Vesuvius the Volcanion with a Shuckabear. I don't remember what I brought on him last week. We have Flamethrower, Steam Eruption, Earth Power, and Power Grass. So this thing is going to be very nice to have this week. Shuckabear is going to be very nice because he does have the ground threats being the extra draw. I believe Scolipede gets Earthquake, could be wrong. I know Darm does, Tyranitar does. So this thing could... Nidoqueen gets Earth Power, so overall, having the Shuckaberry to have the damage of a ground-type move would be very, very nice. Flamethrower just hits well against his entire squad, basically obliterates Scolipede and Excadrill, which could be very, very good. Hits Gourgeist super hard, obliterates it. Steam Eruption is just a really good move on his entire team. Vaporeon can have Water Absorb, which I need to keep an eye on. That's why I'm running in Power Grass, actually, is for the Vaporeon, because it's immune to the Steam Eruption, and pretty much that's why I'm hitting Power Grass. It'll hit Primarina pretty nicely. And then Earth Power, because Earth Power ground overall against his team is just very good. Because he actually has, I believe Gourgeist is actually his only resistance that is an immunity. So it's very nice ground against his team. So pretty cool stuff. As you see, we're running a lot of special attack investment. That's as much as I can run with the Hidden Power Grass EVs. This is at level 50. I built it at level 50 and then put it to level 70 because the stupid thing wouldn't let me export it because of the event. It has to be level 70 because of the event. So, put a lot in special attack, so this thing could be very, very, hit very hard. I put the last four, one on each defense stat because I had that left over. We're running a lot, so this thing's gonna hit like a truck, and it's gonna be able to take a ground-type move and just hit back super hard, so... Volcanion should be very nice this match. Next up, we have the new arrival, Azurra, which we ended up trading for, which I kind of traded for before week one, but we got it now. So, I really like Azelf, because Azelf is a very good offensive Pokemon. As you see this week, we brought this thing special. Azelf here is a Life Orb with Energy Ball, Psychic, Shadow Ball, and Hidden Power Fire. Now, Energy Ball just works well against those two bulky water types. Hits Excadrill very hard. It'll also hit the Tyranitar decently hard, but considering it'll be in the sand, it'll have the special defense boost, won't be that big of a deal. Psychic is very nice for the two poison types, being the Scolipede and the Nidoqueen. It doesn't really hit a lot super effective, because obviously he does have the... Actually, he has no resistances. That's something to keep in mind. Actually, one resistance. He has Latias as a resistance. Excadrill I have moves for, so I'm not really too worried about that. It's also resisted by Excadrill, but yeah. So, Psychic overall does really nicely against this team. Shadow Ball hits those two Ghost types and the Psychic type in Latias very nicely. That's the reason I decided to run that. And then Hidden Power Fire is probably mainly for the Excadrill. That's the thing it hits the best because Shadow Ball would hit Gourgeist better. And, I mean, it hits Scolipede decently, but I wouldn't really need it. That's the reason it was kind of like a four move slot syndrome thing. I wanted to bring HP Fighting, but I couldn't do that because of the EVs of HP Fighting. I need three perfect for an Azelf to be legal, so pretty cool stuff. I'm running enough HP, or I'm running enough speeds, outspeed, max speed, Latias, and the rest went in special defense, and I put as much in special attack as I could, so pretty cool stuff. And finally, Claire making her first appearance, and there's a joke behind this. I was messaging Brendan, I'm like, what should I name my Kyurem? And I remembered, oh, you know what, I'll name it Claire, because she's a frigid bitch. From Echoes, it was just a joke. But, anyways, yes, we have Claire the Kyurem here with the Life Orb, Substitute, Ice Beam, Earth Power, Shadow Ball. Now, Jose suggested Sub Kyurem, because Sub Kyurem works well against his entire team, because if I get a sub up, then I can just run through his team, because this thing has enough coverage with those three moves for his entire squad. Now, Ice just hits everything except Vaporeon and Primarina for at least neutral damage, which is really, I guess, Darmanitan too, for at least initial damage, which is really nice. Earth Power hits that Darmanitan super hard, Excadrill super hard, it just hits a lot of things super hard. Shadow Ball is once again for the Ghost types and the Psychic type, hits them very nicely, because Latias is kind of an issue for this Pokemon, because Latias does outspeed it. I put a decent amount in Special Defense though, because I had enough left over after building to outspeed Excadrill at base 88 speed, so I put the rest in Special Defense so this thing could be good. I also thought it was only base 90, so this thing is faster than I thought it was, which is really nice. And, yeah, so, I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory. Timid Nature with enough speed, outspeed, Excadrill, the rest in Special Defense, and max Special Attack. So that is the team we are bringing for this, for the the Wind Padres, really injured, Yilix, Pachitid. I'm kind of nervous for this match. I'd really love to pull back after the terrible performance I put in last week and letting both Ninetales and Dragonite sit up on me, so... Alright, thanks so much for watching, and let's go Iron Tech.